She was about 13 months and she wasn't pulling up to standing and she wasn't walking yet. And she could stand, I'd always have to put her in a standing position and she would stand and play for a long time. By 15 months, could tell her crawling was more laborsome than it had been. I would put her to stand up and she just would cry. She just didn't want to do it anymore because it was just too hard for her. When we met with the neurologist, he said he wanted her tested for SMA, and from there it was like 3 weeks. We got our diagnosis March 19th.
Spinal muscular atrophy is a genetic disorder. There's progressive weakness, and typically children will die of respiratory failure. The thing about SMA is that this doesn't affect thinking or the brain, so our patients are bright, normal kids. They just are caught in these bodies that have progressive weakness and they really can't move. Nusinersen is a new drug, and we were very fortunate to be involved in the initial trials. Lucy was one of our patients who was involved in a clinical trial. She was a type 2 or a sitter, so already had contractures.
We didn't know she was getting, you know,
yeah, it was
the
double,
sham
double
or the drug.
Sham.
But man, I think it was just within weeks, all of a sudden we were like, we hadn't seen that before. Her left arm, she could get about here.
Mm-hmm.
And then I remember one day, all of a sudden, she went here. And I thought, oh my goodness, you know, because she hadn't been able to do that.
Mm-hmm.
And so it was at that point we started going, okay, I think we're getting the drug here.
And now, just comparing how strong she is now to then, she's come a long, long way.
With Lincoln, we knew there was a 25% chance. You can test early, or you could just wait till he's here. And we just kind of decided, you know what, we'll wait till he's here.
In the middle of being pregnant with him, Spinraza became FDA approved.
Yeah.
Because we had worked on getting nusinersen commercially available at Children's, Lincoln was able to start nusinersen at less than a month of age. And the outcome for him, as you can see, is amazing.
Lincoln's hell on wheels, man. Can I say that on camera? I mean, he's headstrong and honestly, man, I forget he has SMA.
Yeah.
The other day, his sister's wheelchair was in the middle of the living room and he decided he was just going to get up on top of that wheelchair.
At first I was like, oh my gosh, that's so cute. And then it just hit me that he doesn't need it. And he's 23 months. Lucy got her first chair at 23 months.
Yeah.
Lincoln should look exactly like his sister Lucy. There's about an 85% concordance rate for patients who have spinal muscular atrophy. So we would have expected Lincoln to look just like Lucy if he were not treated. But treating him early has really had such beneficial outcomes that I wouldn't be able to tell he had spinal muscular atrophy if I didn't know his genetics.
Children's Colorado, I mean, I can't talk enough about what they've done for our family. There's joy in them. My boy's okay. But there's joy too. Lucy's okay.
Yeah.
She's getting this treatment that is helping her get stronger. You know, it has extended her life and given her so much more quality of life. I always talk about grace. And I always try to tell my kids when we come here, I always point at that hospital and I say, what is that? And they know now to say it's grace. And it is. The men and women that work here, the nurses, the doctors, the staff, just so many good qualities and so much wisdom. It just really is gracious, you know? I mean, I think that's how I feel every time I come here, is just what a gift of grace this place has been to us.